Good morning students, again welcome to computer science class. Today we are going to discuss about the next representation of an algorithm. Okay, already we discussed step form, pseudo classes. In a step form and a pseudo classes, this steps, whatever steps were there, that are written with the some natural language in a step form and in a particular vocabulary in a pseudo classes. But the thing is, using an algorithm, we are giving a step-by-step process to solve a problem or to get a required result. And another way of representing an algorithm is flowchart. Okay, flowchart, in the first two methods, whatever steps you have, that steps are declared, given by using some statements. Okay, but in case of a flowchart, same steps will follow. Okay. But instead of the steps, instead of the written statements, in the flowchart, we'll use standard symbols. Okay, standard symbols. These symbols also gives the step-by-step process to solve a specific problem. Okay, so flowchart is another representation of algorithm, which is a pictorial representation, visual representation of steps. Okay. So as I already said, algorithm is step-by-step process to solve a specific problem. Here, each and every step is presented with the standard symbols. Okay, so these are the statements. In a flowchart, what we'll use in a flowchart, we'll use the standard symbols, and that standard symbols perform some specific actions. Okay, and each and every symbol is linked up with some lines. Okay, arrows and all. Understood? So this is about flowchart. What is a flowchart? Flowchart is a one type of representation of algorithm. It is a visual representation of steps to solve a specific problem. Clear? And here we are supposed to use only the standard symbols. Clear? Here we are supposed to use standard symbols. And each and every symbol is connected with the connecting lines. Here we have a few characteristics of flowchart. First one, it is a visual representation. Visual representation means here we'll use different standard symbols to give the steps. Okay. The next one is each and every step is represented with a standard symbol. Whatever steps you want to write, each and every step, to write a step, what we'll use? We'll use a standard symbol. We won't write the simple statements. Here what we'll use? We'll use the symbols to represent a step. Next, each and every symbol is linked by using a linking lines, connecting lines. Okay, it's also called as a linking lines. Each and every symbol is linked with the linking lines, connecting lines. And here one more thing is, we should use only the standard symbols. Okay, standard symbols only we should use. This is very, very, very important question you can expect in the exam. What is a flowchart? Flowchart is a visual representation of steps which are used to solve a specific problem. It is similar to your pseudocode and step form only, but there what we used simple statements. Statements are used to give a step-by-step process. Here, instead of the statements, what we are using? Standard symbols. Okay, understood? Now, here we have a few advantages of flowchart that we'll discuss now. It will provide the better way to communicate with the different symbols of the system. Okay, so easily you can communicate with the logic of the system. Clear? Using the symbols. The second one is the effective analysis. Using standard symbols, you can easily analyze the problem. Okay, next, third one is proper documentation. This flowchart is a better way for a documentation. It is easy for the documentation. And using this flowchart provides a blueprint for your programming. So it is easy for the programmer for coding and for debugging also. For finding errors also. And next, it is more user friendly, because whatever symbols we are using in our flowcharts, that are all known symbols. Standard symbols. So it is easy for users to design the flowchart, to understand the flowchart, and to analyze the flowcharts. Okay, so these are the advantages. The first one is the communication. This flowcharts provides a better communication. Okay, it will provide the communication between the different symbols, and the user can easily communicate with the program. Next, effective analysis. Using the standard symbol, where is the logic? If the given condition is true, where we are going, everything. It is at a glance you will get. So, using this flowcharts, you can provide a better analysis. Next, proper documentation. This is a flowcharts as the user for a documentation. Okay, it's a good practice for a documentation also. And using this, the user, the programmer can easily, he can code the program and easily he can debug the program. The main advantage of this is, it is very, very, very user friendly. These are the few characteristics, a few advantages. And using this flowcharts, whatever advantages you have, all those advantages you can write in the exam. First one is it's a visual representation. So it is easy for the even new programmers also to understand what is the problem and what is the solution. From where data is coming and where data is going. Okay, what conditions are implemented? How many ways you can give the conditions? Easily the user can find out by using the symbols. Because in a flowcharts we are using a standard symbols only. Okay, all advantages you can write. With the visual representation, what advantages you will get? All those advantages you can write. Now here, we'll discuss about the standard symbols. What you can use in a flowchart. Okay, standard symbols in a flowchart. Here I give you the list of the symbols and the meaning of that symbol also. So here I have given list of symbols what you can use to draw a flowchart. First one is it's a terminal. This symbol is used to start and stop the flowchart. Okay, procedure. It is used to start the procedure and it is used to end the procedure. Next one is a flow lines. Means it defines the action or an order. Action order means in which direction the data is going and from which direction the data is coming. That information is given by using a flow lines. The next one is a connector, which is used to connect different things in the flow chart. Next, input. Example, if you are giving an input. Okay, what symbol you should use? This one. What is an output? You can use this one. And in some textbooks, for input and output, they are given the same symbol. You can write that same symbol for input and output also. The next thing, you can see the assignment. You can see. This is for an assignment and this is for the decision. If you are taking a decision like A greater than B, then you can write this in this symbol only. It's a diamond symbol. Okay. So, it's very, very, very important. Terminal, flow lines, connector, input, output, assignment, decision. Okay, so in the exam, 100% you can expect this question. So, using these symbols, how to design? Using this symbol, how to design a flow chart? Okay, for one program, we'll draw the flow chart. Then you'll come to know how to use this symbol. Okay, so here as I already said, flowchart is the visual representation of process. Okay, so if you want to calculate sum of two numbers, actually what is a process? Here I'll give you a few steps. Actually if you want to calculate sum of two numbers, what you need? Three variables we need. A, B, C. Okay, A, B, C. Next, you need to calculate C equals to A plus B. Next, you need to print. Print C value you want to print. Okay, this is only for sum of two numbers. Now, here as already said, in order to solve a problem, flowchart is a rather representation of algorithm. So here, whatever steps are there, that steps we are representing by using the symbols. So what is the first one? Terminal. Here, start. Okay, next to flow line. After starting, you need to take a input values. Okay, how many input values have given? Two input values, A comma B. Then for input, what symbol we will use? A equals to 10, B equals to 20. Example, two input we are using this symbol. Next, after taking two input values, what you have to do? You need to calculate C value. For C, we use an assignment. C equals to A plus B. After calculating C equals to A plus B, what you have to do? You have to print. Print, same symbol we use, it's better. Print C. Okay, after printing a C, again use the terminal to stop. So this is a simple flow chart to calculate sum of two numbers. This terminal symbol, terminal for starting, and this is for input symbol, and this is the assignment symbol, and this is an output symbol, and this is a stop. Start and stop. Stop. For start and stop, we'll use the same symbol. You can see. You can take screenshot of this. In the exam, 100% you need to draw one flowchart. It's compulsory. You take screenshot of this. But in this, few symbols I have not added. Decision I have not added. So when we you take this, I will explain the this flowchart with the symbol. Now we'll draw the flowchart with the symbol. Clear? See, if it is you want to check whether A value is greater than B or not, there you need to take the decision which one is the biggest value. You need to take the decision. So in that case, we'll use a decision symbol. So before going to the visual representation, first we'll write in a step form. What is the first one? Declare. If you want to check A and B, declare A comma B. I want to compare these two variables. Next, read A comma B. You need to take, you need to read the, means you need to see the values of A and B. Next, if A greater than B, print A. A is the biggest value. Else, print B is the biggest value. This you have to write. Next, the last one is the end. Now, for this, we'll draw the flowchart. Because you are... symbol, new symbol is added. A decision symbol is added. Okay. Now, here we'll draw the flowchart of this. First starting, what symbol we'll use? Terminal we use. It is compulsory to give a start. Flowchart should have a start and a stop symbol. Next, what is the next one? Declare A comma B. And input you take at it. Input. Declare and initialize. Declare and initialize. A. A equals to 10. B equals to 20. Now, A value, B value available. What is the next step? You need to compare these two values. So, what is the next one? In order to compare, what we'll use? We'll use this symbol. If A greater than B, it is a condition, so you will get two directions you will get. If A greater than B, then what happened? If it is A greater than B, then output symbol, for output symbol, print A. If it is yes, if it is no, then print B. After printing either A value or B value, finally it should stop. Stop again, what symbol will use? Terminal. Okay, so here we are using a standard symbols only. Using standard symbols only, you should draw the flowchart. So in the list, whatever symbols I have given, using that only you should draw the flowchart. Clear? Here this symbol again, it is for a terminal. It is for a input. And next, this is a condition. In this, if the condition is true, the data flow line or instruction flow lines go like this. Means if A greater than B, then if A greater than B, then yes, if the condition is true, whatever is there in this output box, that will be printed. And if the condition is false, whatever is there in this box, that will be printed. So finally, after printing either A value or B value, it should be closed. Okay, so using a stop symbol, we'll close this. Understood? So this is about flowchart. Draw this. I'll give you one more flowchart. Now, together we'll practice flowchart now. Here what you have to do is, I'm giving one condition. What is the condition is, if A value is greater than 10, if A value is greater than 10, then 10 will be added to A value. Okay, example, A value is example 20. 20 is greater than 10. Then 10 will be added to that A value. If A value is less than 10, then as it is A value printed. Clear? What is the condition here? Example, this type of programs you will get in a C programming. This type of conditions you will get in a C programming. First, what I am giving? A value 10 I am giving. If A value is greater than 10, then what we are doing? We are adding extra 10 to that A. If 10 value is less than 10, then what we are doing, whatever A value is there, that we are printing. Okay, finally, you have to print A value. If the A value is greater than also, you have to print. If it is less than also, you have to print. Okay, only A value will be printed, but that is an old value. That is a new value, that will decide. See here, I am giving A value. A value equals to 20. So it is A value is greater than 10. So here again, start. After that, how many input values you have? What input you are giving? You are giving only one input. A value you are giving. Okay. So your input symbol is A equals to 20. So after giving A value, you need to implement condition on that value. Okay, so what is the condition here? Example. If A value greater than 10, as already said, if it is a condition, you will get two ways, either true or false. This calls it two-way decision making statement. If it is a true, it is yes, then what should happen? If it is no, what should be? Okay, if it is a yes, you imagine if it is a yes, what should happen? If a value is greater than 10, then here you need to use the assignment, because here we are assigning. Okay, a equals to a plus 20. Example, or 10 or 20, whatever value you want to add, you can add. A value is 20, I am giving. You leave that. Here input value is 20. If a value is greater than 10, but the condition is yes, then a equals to a plus 20, I am adding. Extra 20, I am adding. If you want 10, you can add. 5, you can add. No problem. After that, again, the value should be printed. Print a. Whatever value it may be, that should be printed. Now, if it is less than 10, then simply I want to print a value. I don't want to do any modifications. So, print a. If the condition is true, then only I want to add the value. If the condition is false, I don't want to add the value. Just whatever value is there, that I want to print on the terminal. Clear? So, finally, it should be closed. It should have a stop symbol. I think it is. I will draw it. You can see. See, first start. Next, a value equals to 20. If a value greater than what I am implementing, if it is yes, a equals to a plus 20. If you want, you can add 10. Okay, here I have added 20. Next, after giving a new value, it is an assignment symbol. I want to print. After printing, finally, stop. As I already said, flowchart should have a start and a stop symbol. Now come this side. If the condition is false, then just we are printing A and we are stopping. We are moving to a stop symbol. Clear? Understood? In this, it is again terminal. It is an input symbol. It is a condition symbol. And it is an assignment symbol. And it is a stop. Okay, understood? So, like this, using a flow chart, whatever problem is there, easily, even complicated problems also, easily you can present by using a standard symbols. And complicated problems, complex problems, can be easily analyzed by the user, because it's very friendly. Because standard symbols, where is the condition, where is the assignment, where the data is going, easily even a new user can also find out. Okay, so whatever algorithms you have, a step form, pseudo classes, pseudo code, among all these three algorithms, the flowchart is nowadays used algorithm to represent the steps, what is going inside. Okay, so for programming, we are writing a code. But example, if the new program, non-computer background students were there, or any administration is there, it is difficult for them to identify what is a C programming, what is a C++ programming. Difficult. So, if you are representing pictorially, it is very good. For this, the best example is you are constructing a building. If you are constructing a building, it is easy. Meet, where is the door, where is the window, and how many square feet is there. It is easily you can find it by using a planning. Okay. But whereas if you'll show if you'll explain this many square feet and this is the entry point, this is the exit point, if you'll explain without the planning, it is difficult for them to understand. Okay. Even non-computer background persons also, they can easily understand what is the programming, what is the purpose of the program, and from where the data is coming, where the data is going, what conditions are implemented. Easily you can explain by using a flowchart. So that is why flowcharts are very user friendly and it is very effective for analyzing your programming. Okay, so this is about flowcharts. 100% you can expect one of the algorithm from this three in your final exams. Okay, first one is a step form, the second one is a pseudocode, third one is a flowchart. Clear?